Christian Lum says women are more unsafe today because of feminism. Oh, for fuck's sakes. All right, well, let's see what she has to say. Lori Alexander, a Christian blogger, is convinced that women aren't safe today as opposed to throughout human history, jeez, because of feminism. Alexander, is she somebody famous? Why are we taking her seriously? She must be a big deal. Is she? Yeah, okay. I mean, if Hemet Mehta is covering it, it must be somebody that matters in the Christian community. Alexander, is that her name? Alexander believes that the solution to campus and workplace violence isn't to make those places more accountable for women, but for women to avoid them altogether. Okay, so to keep women safe, they should just not go to work and not go to campuses just to stay safe. Why don't you just put a hijab on them as well?
Yeah. Hemant even mentions that.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, I mean,
just stay home. Just stay in the kitchen, and that would be the safest. Like, that would be the safest thing for all of them.
He's saying here, it's like telling an assault victim to cover herself up more next time, but saying nothing to potential abusers.
Yeah. She then includes snippets from her readers about all the ways that feminism has endangered women. They got assaulted when working as waitresses. They feared, well, I mean, by this argument, men should stay at home as well, because men get, men, you know, when they go out and do construction, they are putting themselves at risk because they could get hurt. Like when they go into cars, they could get car accidents. So women should stay at home. Men should stay at home as well.
Everyone stays at home.
And then the economy just crashed. Right. So, like, okay, then she continues. It says they feared walking home from work alone late at night. Okay, well, then get better police. They were harassed on college campuses, and when there was no father in the picture, they became promiscuous. And okay, and there's no citation for any of this, by the way, it's being pointed out. Therefore, they imply working outside the home or getting a higher education should be avoided at all costs. Well, Lori, is that her name, right? You're so wrong. I don't even know how where to start. First of all, we all admit that feminism has examples of going too far at many places, right? We have examples of that, right? But overall, throughout history, feminism has done so much more good than harm. And these little examples that we find here and there, okay, in my opinion, is just such a tiny... I know a lot of my audience disagrees with this, right? I mean... Feminism, the brand of feminism as a PR thing, like as a brand, has gotten a lot, is ruined, right? So I know a lot of feminists that don't even call themselves feminists anymore. They call themselves women right activists because of how toxic the word feminism.
Yeah, I stopped calling myself a feminist once because of all those stuff.
Yeah, but whatever you call it, like, okay, if say, like, throughout history, it has done so much good for everybody, okay?
Yes.
It has come a long way, and I don't understand what she's talking about. Women, like, she's talking throughout history. You know how easy she's making it for us to refute what she's saying? You know, it used to be normal for armies to invade a city, and every woman were expected to be raped, like, as a reward to the soldiers of the invading army. Like, do you understand how much less rape and assault on women we have? We still have a lot of rape. We still have a lot of assault on women. But do you understand that if you compare it to what we used to have, you know, we have violence. Violence has decreased in history. Rape has decreased. You know, murder from violence. Yeah. All of this has decreased. All of this has decreased. I don't understand why these people just don't like something and they just pull nonsense out of their ass. It's like, oh, feminism is bad. At least if you want to say something against feminism, point to some ridiculous examples that are actually happening. Where did they get these from? They just put it out there. Like, they don't even bother to check if they're saying anything accurate. Honestly, I bet you a lot of people look at this and be like, yeah, it's right. You know, every time there's a good movement, like, against racism, against homophobia, against transphobia, against, you know, there are some movements that do a lot of good. They grow, they become popular, And because they're becoming popular, there's some examples of people take advantage of it, and they overcorrect, and they start making the movement about something that it wasn't originally about, right? So women's rights, feminism was about equality, equal opportunity, okay? It wasn't about privileges. And I understand that there are many examples that you could find about that some people are taking it to extreme levels that looks ridiculous. And those extreme levels, they're the loudest ones, but they don't represent the majority, okay? Again, racism is still a problem. It was always a problem, it's still a problem. People don't believe it, but it's less of a problem now than it has ever been. Okay, again, people look at the news and feel like, what the fuck are you talking about? Well, yeah, because you're not compared to how it was before. But, you know, but it's better, even though we have still a long way to go, it's better because of a lot of activism. But again, because these movements, black rights movements, women rights movement, gay rights movement, because they became very, very popular, a lot of people eventually within these movements are now using the popularity of it for becoming relevant and becoming, you know, heroes in a new tribe that is forming, rather than actually doing things for the to make things less tribal, to make race matter less, to make gender matter less, to make sexual orientation matter less. Which was the whole point of these movements, to make race, gender, sexual orientation, gender, all of this irrelevant. But when you overcorrect, then instead of doing that, you make actually race more relevant on the other side. So you were like, hey, if I am blue, people have an advantage, and green people are suffering and being oppressed, we have to make it so that blue and green doesn't matter. But then you have examples of people like, okay, yeah, green people are being oppressed. Instead of saying like, hey, let's ask for equality, they're like, because I'm green, I'm special, and I demand these things, you know? So there's examples of overcorrection, and feminism has examples of overcorrection as well. But again, let's not lose sight of the fact that this was a movement that has achieved a lot, and it's still relevant, because if you stop fighting, it will still go back. And when you point to social justice warriors, when you point to, you know, crazy feminists, you have to be careful that they represent the minority, and don't let the fact that they are being crazy make us go backwards, right? Because I think like now anti-social justice warrior, narratives is so popular that even pointing to real misogyny, real racism, real homophobia, real transphobia, real ones, when you point that out, people are like, oh, you're a social justice warrior. Like, no, this is not one of those false accusations. I'm pointing out to real shit right now, right? So just be careful that when you call out this nonsense, you don't just like these nonsense was overcorrection, let's not overcorrect back. Let's not bring back a lot of the racism that we managed to get rid of. Because if you look at the data right now, Generation Z is becoming more homophobic and transphobic because of the bad PR that this feminist and this trans right movements and this social justice warriors getting. We're bringing back racism, okay? I mean, I know racism was always there, but this is bad PR for these great movements. But go on, Sopa.
Yeah, I was just wanted to say, like, exactly, I mean, because of like what people are doing, the overcorrection thing, the extreme feminists, the extreme like gender equality and sexual orientation and stuff, like that's causing the new generation to be more homophobic and transphobic than their previous generation. Like,
right
now kids are getting like, oh, they're just favoring girls, like why shouldn't boys be favored now? And they're getting anti-feminist, like they're now trying to suppress girls, saying, oh, that's bullshit, that's some SJW shit and all. Like, some movie, for example, if a movie has a woman protagonist, right, they'll say, oh, this is some SJW shit. Like, no, that movie just has a woman protagonist, doesn't have to mean anything. But someone will say, I mean, not just someone, quite a few people will say, like, that's some SJW shit. And, I mean, this is like going backwards now.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Andres is saying, I honestly find it ironic how this woman is complaining about feminism when she is only able to express those views because of feminism giving women the right to speak that the Bible didn't allow them. Actually, that's a very good point, because why is she even speaking? She's a Christian and the Bible tells women to shut the fuck up, right?
Yeah, I mean, she doesn't realize that she's
right. So you don't want feminism, go with your biblical values and just shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up, anti-feminists.
Right. Okay, do we have anything in the live chat? Let me see. Okay, heresy is saying the feminists today are not the suffragettes of yesteryear, egalitarian is a better definition in my opinion. I don't know about that, because I think even today, if you just sit in your corner and listen to what people say about feminists, they give you the crazy examples, right? But if you actually go to a lot of, you know, because the crazy ones are more interesting and they're the loudest ones. So you might get a bias, you know, what you're hearing about feminists might be, just like a lot of people on the right are always being accused of being xenophobes and homophobes, and most of them aren't. A lot of people on the left and on the leftist movement, I think even within feminist circles, a lot of them are not saying the things that we hear most feminists say. They're just not as loud as the feminists that are crazy, and also they're not as interesting, because the feminists that say crazy things get more coverage. Right, so I think most feminists are actually asking, they're not for asking for privileges, they're not asking for equal outcome, they're asking for equal opportunity, which is a completely reasonable thing to ask for. If you actually go to their circles, I understand, but the crazy ones are growing though.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we are doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.